Okay, again, I'd like to thank everybody for coming out this morning. Just a little housekeeping note, we will have a hard stop of 10:45. I do have to get to work, and this is part of it. We have had the ongoing discussion with DEP over the past several weeks, which has resulted in this agreement, which we're going to be discussing today. The meeting today was at the request of the DEP, and we're going to heed that request. So I guess what I'm going to do is turn this over to Mr. Carew and Mr. Drawls to give us an update on how we got here and what's actually going to be happening today.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, and I'll start with just a brief update on the Water Department. I'll let Tony handle sort of the introduction of the ACO, the context behind that. At the last council meeting, the council did authorize me to go forward, put out an RFP to look for a firm to serve in the capacity of water and sewer utility superintendent. And just to be clear for members of the public, that is not to say that we are looking to privatize the water and sewer department, just the position that was previously filled by Mr. Butler. Staff and professionals are currently reviewing a draft RFP. We hope to have that out as soon as possible. We will provide council with a copy before it does go out, but hopefully within the next week, certainly within the next 2 weeks. Once that goes out, council will hopefully receive multiple qualified proposals, which you'll be able to choose from at a future meeting. In the meantime, the staff that has been filling that role has been doing a good job. They're very happy, very satisfied, and we are moving forward. With that, I'll let Mr. Drawls explain the context behind the ACO, why council is being asked to pass this today.
Thank you, Scott. And really more for the benefit of the folks in the room, because I've discussed the ACO itself with all the members of council before today. It's self-explanatory in the sense that it's been publicized. We did put it on the website yesterday, and I'm aware that it's been copied and redistributed by social media. There's some comments that have been circulated about it that I suppose maybe they'll come up again today during public comment, or not, but we can address them. But essentially what the ACO says is that DEP, with the issues that they've been working on with us through the MOA that we executed in 2015, and some newer issues that we're dealing with, they thought that the more appropriate relationship to have with DEP on everything was by way of an ACO. So they requested that we transition from an MOA to an ACO. We've done that. The terms of the ACO, again, have already been made available. But we are addressing issues that had arisen over the past couple of years, and also a process for moving forward. There was a regulatory issue that we dealt with. The department requested the payment of a monetary penalty of $300. And essentially, as far as the rest of the operative terms of the ACO are concerned and the order itself, it goes, it really doesn't change anything that we've already been doing. The wells at 7 and 9 are off now. They'll remain off until we have interim treatment in place for the tiers of the water that we need to address. And the township has not admitted liability as part of the ACO. We've done it in the nature of a settlement, which is standard form in the regulated community, and we've done that. Department's made some determinations, some findings, their view of the world in terms of how we got here. We had our side of the story as well. Both sides, you know, we didn't see eye to eye on a lot of these issues. The township manager has addressed a number of them, particularly as they relate to gross alpha in the past 6 months to a year. We obviously had a strong position back with DEP rather than fight about it going forward. Certainly the appropriate thing to do, because we are at a point where we are moving forward, and we're going to be handling issues that much better. We're ready to move ahead. This resolves pending regulatory issues and comes up with a format for dealing with our ongoing relationship in a very efficient manner going forward. So that's essentially it, Scott. We do have, more issues we'll be dealing with as far as the water utility is concerned, as far as the interim treatment is concerned. I think that dovetails directly with what you just said, Scott, about hiring of a firm to help us manage those issues on a day-to-day basis so that we get the best service that we possibly can. That process is ongoing and will be resolved quickly. And that's essentially where we stand.
Yeah, and I think the important takeaway from what you just said, Tony, is that while we may not agree with everything that's in this ACO, what's very clear is that we are going to have a relationship with the DEP going forward. We need to have a good relationship with the DEP going forward. We're still going to need to work with them on the approval for the interim and the permanent treatment. We're going to need approval if council wants to hire a firm to be our water and sewer utility superintendent. And obviously there's other issues beyond water that the DEP deals with that we will be dealing with them with. So I agree, this document helps draw a lot of things to conclusion that we've been dealing with for 18 months now. And hopefully we can move forward with significant progress.
At this point, I'm going to open up the floor for public comment on this resolution. Please come up and state your name and address, and speak clearly into the microphone. Okay, seeing none, I will close the floor.
I'm sorry, I was reading brothers.
Okay.
I'm sorry. Danielle Bernecki, 265 North Riding Drive. Good morning.
Good morning.
I just want to ask each member of council, have you read the ACL? Ms. Petrillo?
Yes.
Yes. Ms. Nicolentan?
Of course.
Yes?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Delgado?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Perwood? In the format that it was presented online last night, do any of you have any changes that you would want to make to the document before it is signed?
No further changes are going to be entertained on the document.
Okay. Can I ask council, do any of you have any thoughts on whether you would want to change on the document, or if you agree with the document in whole as it is presented?
What's your point?
I'm asking council a question.
What's your point?
And I guess I'm asking the question back. What is your point?
Okay. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you.
There are a couple of items in the document that I would request council consider before signing. Can I ask who will be the signature on the document? You have the document in front of you. You want to go through? I'll start in the back with item number 52. There's a spot on who your contact will be at the township, and it's not filled in. Has not been identified.
There are spaces for information to be added, and they will be added. That's not a change to the document. You know that. So if that's your point, all that type of information that calls for additional information will be added.
Excellent. So since there will be an opportunity to make some changes to the document,
no, not so.
With item number 55, it talks about what date the first progress report will be issued. Item 35 asks what date the progress report will be issued. The first progress report will be issued.
Correct.
The type of information to be added.
I would just like to call that to the attention as something that will be addressed before it's signed.
We're aware of that.
Item 24. Says Morrisville has agreed to entry of this ACO and to be bound by its terms and conditions and to be bound. Also has emergency interconnections with Maple Shade, 1 8-inch diameter and Mount Laurel, 2 8-inch diameter. I ask that somebody on behalf of the township determine whether or not there's also an emergency interconnect with New Jersey American Water separate from the purchase connections, and if that does exist, that the document be updated to reflect that emergency interconnection, as it may be helpful to the township with future endeavors. At this time, any other comments I have on the ACO with respect to errors in the document are in favor of the township. So I'd like to request to hold my comment on those.
Why would you want to wait?
For the task force meeting, because based upon specifically item number 32, our task force has a lot of work to do.
Okay. So if you have positive things to say, you want to wait to say that?
I think they can stay in the document as they are. They plan to have a favor.
Okay.
I consider myself a teammate of the township. Do you consider me a teammate, Tony?
Is that why when you asked every member of the of council whether they read the document, some other question, you had Mr. Goldman back there videotaping everyone, you answering the question? Is that how the team is?
Wow.
I'm not aware of being videotaped, and I never gave my permission to be videotaped.
Well, then you should pay attention to what you're doing and who's working with you. You should. If you're a teammate, you'd be a teammate.
Tony, do you view me as a teammate?
Right now, no.
Have you viewed me as a teammate for the last 2.5 years?
Do we have any other public comment?
I'm not concerned about you, Daniel. Really?
Wow.
I mean, this isn't about you.
Let's move forward.
So we have an ACO to move forward with.
So I am thankful that council has read the document, because my understanding is council makes the decisions.
Yes, they do.
They are elected officials.
They are.
And they make the determination. And I am thankful that they have read the document and have just relied on their professional staff.
Great.
I hope everybody has a wonderful 4th of July.
You too.
Thank you very much.
J.D. Angelini, 233 Hedgeman Road. I came up on behalf of all the citizens and residents sitting out there, and I'm appalled by your behavior. The town council and the mayor is allowing this gentleman to act like this toward our residents. It's appalling, and you should all question this. And I think you should question his allegiance to our town for acting this way.
Good.
And it really benefits all of us for you guys to sit here and ask him, why is he treating citizens and residents that are here for the good of our town to be treated like this? Your body language, your attitude, the way you speak, it's disrespectful, and it's offensive to everyone out here.
I disagree.
Well, let's take a poll. I think we all hear you. You're talking about people videotaping? Every other town videotapes their meeting. What's wrong with people seeing this?
Do you have a comment to make on this?
I do. I have a question. After Danielle mentioned a task force, I don't think that's been publicly mentioned. What is the task force? Could you explain that and who's on it and who's helping with that?
I'm not aware of any task force.
So you guys haven't met with anyone in the audience or anything discussing ways to make this water situation better? There's no task force behind closed doors or any of that sort of thing?
You're looking straight at me, so
I've looked at everyone. I mean, Is there any kind of minutes or any information we can get from the results of the task force?
Excuse me, it's not a task force. It's me. It's not a task force. It's me.
Excuse me. I a little bit of housekeeping here. I've just been informed by Patty that we have to keep our comments to the resolution. We cannot, since this is a special comment.
Okay, so this is
comments on that.
My next question is, I see a member of council not here. I would think that this would be a really important meeting for her to be at. Do you know if she's even read the ACF?
She has got a copy. Just due to the nature of her business, she couldn't get away on that.
So that's more important than our town and the water?
I'm not going to answer this.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm going to close the floor for public comment and ask council for comments.
So this has been something we've been talking about for a while. We met over the last year or so talking about the water in town. I think we continue to make the right steps. I think we're headed in the right direction, moving towards the interim treatment. That interim treatment 10 months ago, we talked about doing radiological, so we're ahead of the game, ahead of this ACO on that. And I think we're heading in the right direction. I think every decision we've made is just moving the utility, particularly around for generations and serve the people in this town for generations in a good way. I think the monitoring that we're under now is probably the most stringent and tough monitoring that we've ever been under the UCM3. And I think we're doing right by that as well. If we miss one little thing here and there, yes, and we're going to correct that. But overall, I think that this utility has served the people who have done very well and continue to do so in the future.
Thank you. Lisa?
I have a question for comment. On number 35, it talks about all the reporting that we need to do, the types of reporting that's required. Will that reporting be shared with council and the public as it is submitted to the DEP?
Yes, the progress reports will be public documents that obviously we'll share with the council when the document is available to the public. Okay. Most likely put on our website. In terms of the progress report and the question that you asked earlier about who the contact person was, going to be, if you read the orders and what's going to be required by the township, it's not going to be one person. So the plan was, and we discussed this in the individual meeting, was that assuming council passes this today, will be a subsequent meeting with staff and professionals to determine and identify who's going to be doing what. We'll share that with council in terms of the identification of what staff member or what professional will be dealing with what. It certainly won't be one person dealing with everything. So when it gets past that, we'll have an update for council on that in the very near future.
And then in 54, it talks about compliance visits, but they didn't give like the terms of that. Do they need to be notified or can they just show up? So I would imagine we're okay with them just showing up to do whatever they need to take a look at if they need to come.
They have the authority to do that.
Okay, so that's good. So comment on this. As people have read this, it's very readable, it's very clear. But in my opinion, it's also distressing and alarming in its clarity. Dating back to 2013 to 2015, we've been in multiple violations of the Safe Drinking Water Act. So while the violations are bad enough, I think on a larger level, we're talking about more than the violations. We're talking about credibility and accountability. We're talking about a possible loss in public trust in our leadership. And how do you put a price on that? We're paying a $3,000 fine. But if there is some loss in that public trust in this leadership, you know, how do you get that back? How do you put a price on that? So we can sit here and we can debate as long as we want about the findings. But the bottom line is, this is about public health and safety. And I believe it's also about betraying public trust. And we need to hold ourselves accountable. We're doing some of that by way of this. And I think it's also a time that we need to reflect in going forward, holding ourselves to a different standard. You know, we have to do better going forward with things like this. So That's what I have to say about moving forward. I'm hoping we can keep it closing as soon as possible. I'm hoping we get the approval from the DEP. As soon as this thing gets signed and turned in, I have no problem signing this. I just hope there has not been a breach in the public trust and leadership in this town. Let's say thank you.
Victoria?
Well, I think the man really put it best, but I mean, the only thing I would add is just that, clearly I have no issue signing this because it really is just codifying what we would have been doing anyway, which is installing a treatment for what we're finding in the water and making the water as good as we possibly can. I mean, that's been our goal from the start. And so if the DEP would like us to formalize that, I don't have a problem with that.
Yeah, I think that the bottom line here is that this document enables us to move forward and to move forward at good pace, with a transparent pace. Our reporting standards are going to be that the public will feel the confidence in our reporting, in our water, and in our infrastructure, and in the new leadership of the utility. And I think that's very important for people to know that this utility is moving forward in a bolder and newer fashion, and we will be at the top of our game. So with that, I'd like to entertain a motion to, can we do this by roll call or, okay. I'd like to have a motion to accept the ACO as written.
We're adopting resolution.
Adopting resolution 136-2016. Is there a motion to accept? Is there a second?
Yeah.
Roll call vote, please.
I'm sorry, Ms. Andriola?
Yes.
Ms. Napolitano?
Yes.
Mr. Novara?
Yes.
Ms. Mayo?
Yes. Meeting adjourned.